Good evening, children.
Today we are going to revise maths. So what are we going to revise? We are going to revise maths. Okay, so the first topic we are going to revise in maths is number flubs. What are we going to revise? Number flubs. First one, the numbers from 1 to 9 are one digit numbers. The numbers from 1 to 9 are one digit numbers. In the dash you should write O-N-E, 1. O-N-E, 1. Second one, the numbers from 10 to 99 are two digit numbers. T-W-O, 2. The numbers from 10 to 99 are two digit numbers. Third fill in the blanks. The numbers from 100 to 999 are three-digit numbers. The numbers from 100 to 999 are three-digit numbers. Fourth one. The smallest one-digit number is 1. The smallest one-digit number is 1. The smallest one-digit number is 1. Fifth one. The smallest two-digit number is 10. The smallest two-digit number is 10. Sixth one. The smallest three-digit number is 100. The smallest three-digit number is 100. Next one. Seventh one. The biggest one-digit number is 9. The biggest one-digit number is 9. So eighth one. The biggest two-digit number is 99. The biggest two-digit number is 99. The last one. The biggest three-digit number is 999. The biggest three-digit number is 999. So this is the number flubs. Next, we are going to revise number names 1 to 20. We are going to revise number names 1 to 20. O-N-E-1. O-N-E-1. T-W-O-2. T-W-O-2. T-H-R-E-E, 3. T-H-R-E-E, 3. F-O-U-R, 4. F-O-U-R, 4. F-I-V-E, 5. F-I-V-E, 5. S-I-X, 6. S-I-X, 6. S E V E N 7. S E V E N 7. E I G H T 8. E I G H T 8. N I N E 9. N I N E 9. T E N 10. T E N 10. This is the number names from 1 to 10. Next, we are going to revise 11 to 20. E L E V E N 11. E L E V E N 11. T W E L V E 12. T W E L V E 12. T H I R T E E N 13. T H I R T E E N 13. F O U R T E E N 14. F O U R T E E N 14. F I F T E N 15. 15. F-I-S-T-E-E-N, 15. S-I-X-T-E-E-N, 16. S-I-X-T-E-N, 16. S-E-V-E-N-T-E-E-N, 17. S-E-V-E-N-T-E-E-N, 17. E-I-G-H-T-E-E-N, 18. E-I-G-H-T-E-E-N, 18. N-I-N-E-T-E-E-N, 19. N-I-N-E-T-E-E-N, 19. T-W-E-N-T-Y, 20. T-W-E-N-T-Y, 20. This is the number name from 11 to 20. Next, we are going to revise in tenses, number names in tens. First one, 10. T-E-N, 10. T-E-N, 10. Next number, 20. T-W-E-N-T-Y, 20. T-W-E-N-T-Y, 20. T-H-I-R-T-Y, 30. T-H-I-R-T-Y, 30. F-O-R-T-Y, 40. F-O-R-T-Y, 40. F-I-F-T-Y, 50. F-I-F T-Y, 50. S-I-X T-Y, 60. S-I-X T-Y, 60. S-E-V-E-N T-Y, 70. S-E-V-E-N T-Y, 70. E-I-G-H-T-Y, 80. E-I-G-H-T Y, A, T, N, I, N, E, T, Y, 90, N, I, N, E, T, Y, 90,
100, O, N, E, H, U, N, D, R, E, D, 100, 100, O, N, E, H, U, N, D, R, E, D, 100.
Yes, children, like you all have names, even the number has names. So that is what we have revised now. So we are going to revise the next one, write the number names. We are going to revise, write the number names. So what number can you see there? 28. So we are going to say the spelling, we are going to say the number names for this 28. T-W-E-N-T-Y, 20. T-W-E-N-T-Y, 20. 8. E-I-G-H-T, 8. E-I-G-H-T, 8. Next one, 45. 45, 45. We're going to write the number name. F-O-R-T-Y, 40. F O R T Y 40. F I V E 5. F I V E 5. The next one, 307. 307. T H R E E 3. T H R E E 3. H U N D R E D 100. H U N D R E D 100. A N D and. A N D and. S E V E N 7. S E V E N 7. So what is the number there? 307. So this is write the number names. Next we are going to revise. Write the numerals. write the numerals, write the number names. We will give you the number. You have to write their names. The next one, write the numerals. We will give you the names. You have to write the numbers. SIXTYTWO. What is that? Yes. 6 to 62. 62. So what we should write there? 62. Next. ONE. 1. HUNDRED. 100. AND. And. THIRTY. 30. FIVE. 5. 135. How will you write the number? 1, 3, 5. Yes, the last one. NINETY. 90. EIGHT. 8. So how will you write the number? 9, 8, 98. So this is write the numerals. So we have revised the number names and write the numerals. Next, we are going to the next topic. The next topic is ordinal numbers. So what are ordinal numbers? The ordinal numbers refer to the position of the numbers. The ordinal numbers refer to the position of the numbers. Okay, can you see that? First, yes, first. F-I-R-S-T, first. F-I-R-S-T, first. Write number 1 and S-T on top. F-I-R-S-T, first. Second, write number 2 and N-D on top. Second, S-E-C-O-N-D, second. S-E-C-O-N-D, second. Next one, write number 3 and R-D on top. T-H-I-R-D, third. T-H-I-R-D, third. Next, write number 4, T-H on top. F-O-U-R-T-H, fourth. F-O-U-R-T-H, fourth. Next, write number 5 and T-H on top. Spelling is F-I-F-T-H, fifth. F-I-F-T-H, fifth. Next, write number 6 and write T-H on top. Spelling is S-I-X-T-H, sixth. S-I-X-T-H, sixth. Next, write number 7, T-H on top. S-E-V-E-N-T-H, seventh. S-E-V-E-N-T-H, seventh. Next, write number 8, T-H on top. And the spelling is E-I-G-H, T-H, 8. E-I-G-H, T-H, 8. Next, write number 9, T-H on top. N-I-N-T-H, 9. You should not write N-I-N-E, it is wrong. You should write N-I-N-T-H, 9. Last one, write number 10 and T-H on top. 10th, T-E-N. T-H, tenth.
T-E-N-T-H, tenth.
Okay, the next topic we're going to revise, place value. Place value tells value of the numbers. Place value tells the value of the numbers. So, where the number is, it tells the place value for that. Okay, so wherever you see place value, you have to write it in a L shape. When you see a place value heading, you have to draw a L shaped line. Okay, see the first sum, 28. I've given 28. I will draw L-shaped line under 8 and under 2. So what is the place value for 8 there? Place value for 8 is 1s. And what is the place value for 2? It is 10s. So you should write under the L shape, you should write 8 1s. O-N-E-S, 1s. Write number 8 and 1s. The next one, 2 10s. T-E-N-S, tens, T-E-N-S, tens. Or you can write in numbers. Or you can write in numbers like 8 or 2, 0, 20, 8. 8 is in 1's place, so you write 8. 2 is in 10's place, you will write 20. Okay, next sum. Next sum, 2, 4, 6. 2, 4, 6. 246. You're going to find the place value. Draw the L line, L shaped line. Okay, first one, 6. 6 is in which place? 6 is in 1's place. 6, 1's. O-N-E-S, 1's. The next one is 4. 4 is in which place? 10's. 4, 10's. T-E-N-S, 10's. 4, 10's. The place value for 2. So where is the 2? 2 is in 100's place. 2 hundreds. H-U-N-D-R-E-D-S. Hundreds. 2 hundreds. Or you can write in numbers like this. 6. 6 is in 1. So only 6 you should write. Then 4 tens. So 4 is in tens place. What will you write? 40. 40. And then 200. 2 is in which place? It is in hundreds place. So you should write 200, 200. Okay, the next sum. The next sum is 140. 140. 140. Okay, draw the L shape. Zero is in which place? Ones place. So you write 0, ones. O-N-E-S, ones. O-N-E-S, ones. Next number. 4. 4 is in which place? Tens place. So you will write 4 tens. T-E-N-S, tens. T-E-N-S, tens. Next is 1. 1 is in which place? Hundreds place. So 100. H-U-N-D-R-E-D, hundred. H-U-N-D-R-E-D, hundred. So how can you write this in number? 0 is in 1's place, so only 0 must be written. 4 is in 10's place, you should write 4040. 1 is in 100's place, so you should write 100, 100. Okay children, did you all understood the place value? Yes, so this is the place, and if you see place value, you must draw the L-shaped line. The next topic we are going to see is pictorial representation.
Can you see this? This big box denotes 100. This thin strip denotes 110. This small box denotes 11. Pictorial representation means we will give you the box. You have to write the numbers. Pictorial representation means we will give you the box. You have to write the numbers.
First, can you see? Yes, I have drawn only 4 thin strip boxes. I have drawn 4 tens boxes. Is there any 100 box there? No. Is there any small box there? No. So how many tens boxes there? 4. I will write number 4. There is no ones box, so I will put a 0 at the side. So 40. Okay? 40. Yes. Can you see the next box? Yes, one big box, 100 boxes there. Is there any tens box? No tens box. And there are 2 small box, one big box, no tens box, and 2 ones box, small box. Okay, so what is the number you have to write? 100. Is there any tens box? No, so you should write 0. And how many small boxes there? 2 small box. Okay, now the third example. Can you see the boxes there? Yes, I have drawn 2 big box. How many big box? 2 big box and 2 tens box. I have drawn 2 tens box and 3 small box. So 2 big box, 100 box, 2 tens box and 3 small boxes. So 223. You have to write 223. So these are the examples for
pictorial representation. Represent pictorially means we will give you the numbers. You have to draw the boxes. Represent pictorially means we will give you the numbers. You have to draw the boxes.
Okay. First number 25. First number 25. So how many boxes you should draw? Is there any big box I should draw? 2 is in tens place. So how many tens boxes I should draw? 2 tens boxes. So I will draw 2 thin strip boxes. And then 5. 5 is in ones place. So ones place, what box I should draw? Ones box, small boxes. So I will draw 5 small boxes. So 25. Next up, 123. 123. Now we are going to draw the boxes for that. 100. So you should draw a big box. How many big box? 100 box you should draw? It is only 100. You should draw one big box. And then next, tens place. Tens place, what it is there? 2. So how many tens boxes you should draw? 2 tens box. So 2 thin strips box I should draw. Next. Next, what number is there? 3. 3 is in which place? Ones place. So I should draw ones box. 3 ones box I should draw. So I should draw one big box, 2 thin strip box and 3 small boxes. Okay, this is the first sum and the second sum is 123. Let us see the next sum. The next sum is 14. The next sum is 14. 14, how will you draw? You will draw 1 thin strip box. 1 thin, 14 means 10. 10 is in 10's place, what is there? 1. So 1 thin strip box and 4 small boxes. You should draw 4 small boxes. Okay, so 14. So this is represent pictorially means we will give you the numbers. You have to draw the boxes. Let us go to the next topic. The next topic is very, very easy, children. Before, after and between numbers. We're going to learn before, after and between numbers. Okay, now first one, if you see the first example, we're going to learn about before number. Before number means the number which comes before. We're going to see the number which comes before. You all know 1, 2, 3, right? Yes, you should find out the number which comes before. Okay, we will give you the dashes. You have to write the numbers. So, dash, dash, 37, 38. Dash, dash, 37, 38. So, what are the before numbers can come? Okay, 37, 38 I have given. So, before 37, what will come? Before number? Before 37, 36. 36, you have to write 36. Before 36, what will come? 35. Before 36, 35. Okay, next example. Dash, dash, 108, 109. Dash, dash, 108 and 109. So, we are going to see what number comes before 108. So, 109 I have given. So, what we are going to see what comes before 108. Before 108, what number will come? 107. 107. 107. So, what comes before 107? One more dash is there, right? What comes before 107? 106. 106. 106. 106. So, these are the two examples for before number. Next, we are going to see after number. After number means the number, the dashes will come after. So, we are going to see the after number. 28, 29, dash, dash. 28, 29, dash, dash. So, what number comes after? What number comes after? 28, 29. 30. What number comes after 29? 30. You have to write 30. What number comes after 30? 31. After 30? 31. Okay, next example. 219, 220, dash, dash. What will come after 220? Because after 219, I have given 220. After 220, what will come? Very good, children. 221. After 221, what will come? 222. 221 and 222. So these are the examples for after number. Now we are going to revise between numbers. So numbers will be missing in the between of two numbers. So we are going to find out. Okay. So 14, 15, dash, dash, 18, 19. Okay. Now let us see what comes after 14, 15. I have written there. What comes after 15? 16. You should write 16. What comes after 16? 17. 18 I have written and 19 also is there. That is the first example. Next example. 325, 326, dash, dash, 329 and 330. So what are the numbers missing there? 325 after 325, 326. After 326, 327. After 327, 328. After 328, 329 is written there. And then 330. Okay, children. So this is between numbers. Hope you all understood the sums. Now I'm going to give a small recap from the beginning. Okay, so first what did we learn? We learned fill in the blanks. Fill in the blanks in numbers. We learned fill in the blanks in numbers. Next, we have learned number names. So we all have names like that. Even numbers have names. So we have revised like write the number name. We have revised 1 to 20 number names and then 10 to 100 number names. Next, write the number names. I gave you the numbers and we have to write their names. Next, we write the numerals. Write the numerals. We will give you the names and you have to write the numbers. We will give you the name of the number and you have to write the numbers. Next, what we see in ordinal numbers. Ordinal numbers refers the position of the number. The ordinal numbers refers the position. So first, second, third, and okay, you should not write just 1, 2, 3, 4. You should not write. If you write 1, you should write ST on top. That is tells the position. Okay, next we have revised place value. Next we revise place value. When you see place value, it tells you the value of the numbers. It tells you the value of the numbers. You have to draw a L-shaped line and write the number names. Maybe in names or in numbers. Next, we have learned pictorial representation.
Pictorial representation means we will give you the box. You have to write the numbers. Represent pictorially means we will give you the numbers. You have to draw the boxes.
And the last topic is before, after, between numbers. So where are the numbers missing? You have to fill. Before number is missing, you have to fill the before number. The numbers are missing after the numbers. Like dash is there, you have to fill after numbers. And then between numbers. So between two numbers is missing, that you should fill. Okay, children. Hope you all understood maths revision today. Thank you, children. Have a good day.